circle is in a Cartesian product. Let us consider the following two sets. How many sets they are taking? Two sets. A is the set of three vegetables and B is the set of four fruits. So, A is the set of vegetables. How many vegetables are there? Three vegetables. And B is the set of fruits. How many fruits are there? Four. That is, A equal to carrot, brinjal, lady's finger. And B equal to apple, orange, grapes, strawberry. So, what is the question they have given here? What are the possible ways of choosing a vegetable with a fruit? So, while you are taking a vegetable, what are the possible ways to have a fruit along with it? So, carrot. First, you are choosing carrot. Vegetable carrot. So, with vegetable carrot, what are the possible ways? What are the fruits you can have? First choice, just you see the line here. What is given? Green color line. Carrot, apple. Carrot, orange. Carrot, grapes. Carrot, strawberry. So, you are writing both carrot, apple. With carrot, you are eating apple. You are choosing apple. So, how can we write carrot and, isn't it? Carrot, comma, apple. Isn't it? So, ordered pair. You can write it in a pair. You can write it in a pair. Next one is what? Carrot, comma, orange. Carrot, comma, orange. Next one is carrot, comma, grapes. Next one is carrot, comma, strawberry. Is it okay? Next to what? Brinjal. Next one is what? Brinjal. Along with brinjal, what are the possible ways you can have the fruit? Brinjal, apple. Brinjal, orange. Brinjal, grapes. Brinjal, strawberry. So, here they have given you, see. For carrot, four possible ways. For brinjal, four possible ways. Next one is lady's finger. For lady's finger, how many possible ways? Same thing. Red line you see. Here. Sorry. Here you can have. Instead of red, here you can have blue. Isn't it? Because they have given blue line. Blue. Next one is what? Lady's finger. Lady's finger. Along with lady's finger, what are the possibilities they have given? Here, red. Four possibilities are there. For brinjal also, four possibilities. So, totally, how many pairs are there? 12 pairs are there. Totally, how many pairs are there? 12 pairs are there. So, this collection represents the Cartesian product of the set of vegetables and set of fruits. It is a collection. It is a collection. So, it is a collection of ordered pairs. It is a collection of ordered pairs. So, this collection represents the Cartesian product. So, Cartesian product is nothing but the collection of ordered pairs. The collection of ordered pairs. So, it could be represented with set bracket. So what is the definition they have given? So you should know the definition for Cartesian product. So define Cartesian product, they may ask in 2 mark. If A and B are two non-empty sets. So first point is this. If A and B are two non-empty sets. So this is the condition. Both the sets should have an element. At least one element should be there. So it should not be an empty set. So if A and B are two non-empty sets, while I am teaching, please just you memorize along with me. You should understand the concept and you will be able to produce the definition on the spot while they are asking. If A and B are two non-empty sets, then the set of all ordered pairs, then the set of all ordered pairs. What is ordered pair in general we are taking? A comma B. You can write X comma Y also, no problem. Just you are taking an alphabet. You are using alphabets to represent the ordered pair. Then the set of all ordered pairs A comma B, such that A is an element of set A. B is an element of set B. Is called the Cartesian product of A and B. So this no need to by heart because this will be there. Cartesian product of A and B. Define Cartesian product. Suppose if you are taking X and Y, then it will have like this. X is an element of A, X. Then Y is an element of set Y. The set should be represented with the capital letters. The name of the set should be represented with the capital letters. Understand? So, and it is denoted by A cross B. What is the symbolic representation? A cross B. Suppose if you are unable to express this type of definition, you can give it in the form of set builder form. A cross B equal to A comma B. A comma B, because this is given set of all ordered pairs A comma B. So we are writing like this. A comma B, such that A is an element of set A. B is an element of set B. So even though you are unable to give it in a sentence, for your lifelong you will be able to say this. A cross B equal to, within the set bracket, what you should write? A comma B ordered pair. You have to write it in a pair such that A is an element of set A and B is an element of set B. So 2 mark you can get, and also the concept is very clear, isn't it? So Cartesian product of A and B is nothing but the set of all ordered pairs. Suppose if you want to give it in precise, set of all, it is a collection of set of all ordered pairs. That's all. It is a collection of set of all ordered pairs. So it is a collection of ordered pairs. Otherwise, set of all ordered pairs. So no need to say collection of set of all ordered pairs. Sorry. Set of all ordered pairs. Otherwise, collection of ordered pairs. That's enough. It is a collection. What is meant by set? Collection of well-defined object. What is meant by set? It is a collection of well-defined object. So, in the word set itself, there is a collection. So, set of all ordered pairs. Otherwise, it is a collection of ordered pairs. Why we are saying instead of collection of all ordered pairs, we are saying set? Because we are writing in a set bracket. We are writing in a set bracket. It is a set. It is not only a collection. It is not only a collection. It is a set. Because it is well defined. So, proper way of expressing a Cartesian product definition is set of all ordered pairs. That's all. Do you follow?